Man, this comic book sucks! And the reviews online said it was good! I wasted my money! Why didn't somebody tell me?!
Hey everybody, we have our last review of today. This is going to be Predator, the Hunters. That's issue one that we're reviewing. There's two issues out. We decided to review the first one since it just started. This is Petey right here, and we have
Calvin Ellis, still rocking and rolling.
So, in this one, we have a story where we start out where they're in the jungle, like any Predator story is supposed to start out. And they're being chased, the Predator's taking out, mowing through people, and then they're about to fight with the last human left, and then the human falls in the, what's the name, waterfall, and escapes. So then we cut to this, it looks like a gas station, but they also have like, snakes to feed, and then these people come to meet this guy who survived or has killed a Predator. And it's actually a group of people that have killed Predators. And they're recruiting him, of course, you know, like, it's almost like a movie, like, no, I don't want to do this, that, and the other. But they tell him their history of being Predator hunters. And, of course, this guy doesn't like the job he's in. He's at a gas station. He's feeding snakes. So he has a moment where he has to leave, and then he joins them. But, he's reluctant to join them. But they hear a little more of their story. And it's more, they could have got a little more into this issue, but, you know, I haven't read most of the Predator, and I think with the writer Chris Warner, he was involved in the Predator comic, which led to the second movie. The comic is a lot better than the second movie, but Chris Warner's been involved with Predator for so long. So, I mean, I guess he is a conceit of being that sort of person that's been there for that long. You allow him some leeway. I haven't read those books, but I'm sort of interested to see what happens. I just want a little more, as I always say, but, you know, it's okay. That's all I can say. What do you say about this book?
I'm pretty much in line with the same thing. I remember some of the characters. I read the earlier Predator series from Dark Horse years ago. So I still remember the characters from there. And one of the things that immediately took me out is one of the characters, he wasn't a jerk or this guy who's going to be set up to show how tough the other ones are by keep getting beat up. So, you know, he of course he says something to one woman and she puts him on his ass. Says something to this other woman and she puts him on his ass. And I'm like, I don't understand why he's acting like that. That's not the character I was introduced to, mm-hmm. unless there's been some stories with him in between that. Mm-hmm. But you would think it would only take once, you know, for you to do it. And then what's worse than that is because they keep putting it on his ass, I don't believe this guy would be able to take on a Predator. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, you did that to, I guess, demonstrate that these characters are at least better fighters than him or competent. But you make him look less in the meantime, and we got to go fight Predators. I think the hardest thing with the Predator series is that they keep, at least for me, they want to get, I think the first time they do it, they've got it. Mm-hmm. And the first thing they've done, it beat the first Predator movie. They've also done Aliens versus Predator, and they did the first Predator comic series. All three of those work because they were breaking new ground. The Predator was just great because you had all these muscle-bound guys, you know, you'd be afraid of in real life, and they're running. Mm-hmm. Okay, yeah. Make it to the chopper. You know, they're running.
Get to the chopper.
In the comic, they shifted. Instead of the Predator being in a jungle, they shifted, and now the Predator was hunting people inside of a city, a concrete jungle. That works. And then the last one, Predator versus Alien. It's the Predator versus the aliens. These are the mm-hmm. ultimate hunter. Okay, against the prey that you don't want to have to go against.
Yeah.
It really works very well for them. It's everything ensuing afterwards where they seem to have some difficulty with it, because who in their right mind wants to go hunt a Predator? After a while with the aliens, you know what the answer has to be. Nuke these guys. Don't get anywhere close to them.
Yeah.
So in the comic, I'm like, what kind of ground are they trying to break here? I already know why I should be afraid of the Predator. But if these guys are successful in hunting Predators, then you've totally undercut what is scary about the Predator.
That's a key reason against the book, yes.
Yeah, so, you know, I mean, to be honest, I'm interested in seeing, it's not something I would necessarily recommend for other people to put money down on, but I'm interested in seeing where the book wraps up.
Yeah.
especially since there's supposed to be another Predator film coming down the pike soon. So mm-hmm. I'm interested. I didn't see the last Alien film, but I'm interested in seeing where this goes and then maybe where they would go for the next Predator film. I like the last one with them being stuck on the planet. The only problem is, you know, so what if you beat the Predator? You're stuck on this planet.
With the Adrian Brody one?
Yeah.
Only problem is you're stuck with Adrian Brody.
That's too.
That's the other. Otherwise, the movie was okay.
So you have a nice little bit of twists and turns mm-hmm. there. You know, Topher Grace, you know, with some nice twists and turns there. Mm-hmm. But at the end of the day, it's like, yeah, we beat the Predator, but you're stuck there. You know, mm-hmm. How are you getting off this planet?
Mm-hmm.
So it's things of that nature where the first one was the best one. It's probably one of the best action movies of all time.
Yeah. It's also, I mean, like the second one is a little too much of a Hollywood movie because they had the scene on a train where everyone pulls out a gun on a train. So they had a little too much tongue-in-cheek, which you couldn't believe it. But, and Danny, you know, what's his name?
Danny Glover's
just like, he's taking the weapon from the Predator, killing the Predator, whereas the key part of it was Arnold is matched up and found a way to even the odds. And even then, he can't win. Like, and even then, he's getting slapped around, knocked around. And his trap only works inadvertently. He has to, call an audible and switch it, and then he stops the Predator.
Well, I thought his thing, he was just lucky.
Yeah.
Okay, because it wasn't he was the best fighter or anything. He just lucked out with the mud, and then he mm-hmm. gets lucky again.
Yeah.
So he was just lucky. That's how he was able to get through it. With Danny Glover's character, I just, you know, especially with his last name, I just attributed to him just being tough, that he was able to, he was just able to last long enough.
Did you believe he could do that to a Predator? Take the blade and just gut him? Like, he just took him out.
It didn't look like it would take a lot of power to do it. He was just tough, okay? Because the whole scene where the Predator's hanging onto his arm, okay, mm-hmm. the Predator's hanging on to it, and he's like, okay, I just got to get this. If I can get this, I can get him off. And he's able to slice him off. Where I started disbelieving was, okay, the Predator's running away now. He's like, I got to go after him. I'm like, oh, wait, no, you don't. No, you don't.
It was man.
I thought those were the two best out of the franchise. Mm-hmm. You know, and some of the other ones I may have enjoyed, but those were the two best. But I thought this guy wins, he wins because he's lucky, okay? Mm-hmm. He's not necessarily stronger or better, he's just lucky. And the other guy was just tough. He was able to hang on until he got his moment, and he got his moment. Everything mm-hmm. after that, is like, even with the last one, it's hard for me to distill what exactly goes here, except for, other than the fact that, okay, you know, I win because I'm the human and I'm mm-hmm. supposed to win in this. In the comic, again, I think you need your head examined if you want to go and hunt a Predator. And if you're successful, you have totally undercut the reason why the Predator works as a character. If you're successful there, then what's it going to become? Like interplanetary war? But you know, for the because mm-hmm. the Predators seemed like, hey, they don't like to lose.
Yeah.
Okay. If I'm going to lose, I'm going to take out everything. I'm going to have this samurai death. I'm going to do seppuku, but I'm taking out everything with me.
It's
if it comes down to it, more than that.
It's like I'm not even giving you the opportunity to win. Like I'm destroying like half of the area. I'm just taking you with me. I don't want to lean towards the three. I want to do my usual two, but say go out and check it out, and I want to see the end. You were saying you're not going to necessarily recommend, but
want to see where this goes. Yeah. In good conscience, I can't recommend it for anyone else. Yeah. So it's about a two.
Okay, so there we go with the twos, and I just wanted to highlight seeing that Chris Warner is he was originally an artist who was in he did the Doctor Strange after who was it. He did it after Roger Stern and Paul Smith. So it's interesting to see that he's had this long career, like the Norman Comics, he did the Terminator, he did Predator Comics,
right.
The first one before they did the movie, and then he did Comics Greatest World where he created half of some of those characters. It was interesting to just see that he's still been a mainstay at Dark Horse. I miss seeing his art. He was a real solid artist, he did good like superhero type characters. But, you know, just want to highlight that. And that's it for us today.
One note, you know, we usually have a producer here who's always down on us saying, hey, why do you guys review books that you don't like? Well, a lot of the books, we don't know if we're going to like them or not until we read them.
Yes.
So if you guys, if this is good stuff out there, you're like, hey, why don't you read this? You know, we're open to recommendations. We're open to suggestions. Mm-hmm. Leave some comments. Okay, hey, why don't we check this out? I think we did a couple of, those weren't normal reviews when we did Avengers Forever, that type of stuff. But yeah, if there's some stuff out there and we're just not hip to it, hip us to it. We have no problem. Other than that, we call it like we see it based on what we get.
And if that's the thing, if you don't like, if you say like Saga, we kind of were rough on it. Point us out to the issues that you think are the key ones. We'll try to review that. I mean, we're trying to stay one. We're not necessarily doing, if we were to do a trade, then we would do just like Avengers Forever. So we can do that. But there's a specific issue just to say, hey, this would point out all the key stuff. I would love to do that too. So thank you.
Thanks.
And subscribe, like, and do whatever, or dislike. Let us know. We'd like to fight. We can fight it out in, you know, in the comments. So thank you, everyone.
See you there.
Thanks, Benarac. You saved me money.